Hi, this is Roger. Thanks for dropping by. This is going to be an attempt at a main update. I don't know whether to call it a July update, as we're a week into August, but an update anyway. It's early in the morning, light level's relatively low for the UK, but it's coming on. Just started watering, so Vanda's getting dunked and hung up to drip so they don't go on the other plants. I don't need to water anything apart from dahlias today because we had a good session yesterday and the day before. So what I'm going to do is go around by genera, because obviously they're all over the place and things will have to be moved and it's going to be fiddly. So it's going to be one of those videos where it sort of stops and starts in sections, but I'll, with the magic of technology, join them all together and make one video. I also need to do an update on the ceramist project. Some success, some failure. I was expecting some failure simply because a lot of the plants that went in the ceramist had no roots and quite honestly didn't have any hope really. So we'll see how we get on. So just a quick scan round to start. Just sort of showing where things live and stuff that lives up high. And you know, I work in layers. Plants higher up get the brightest light, ones underneath them get not so much light, get a bit of shade from plants above. Some plants have got their own little microclimate because they live directly under quite a large plant. So although they're on a high layer, they're not getting the high light. I have to fiddle around like that. You know, each plant gets looked at individually and placed to the best of my ability in a place I think it's gonna do the best of the space available. Okay, so I'll start in sections. I'll try not to make it too long. Okay, my Paphiopedilums. Not my favourite plant, they are just very, very slow growing. This one here is a bit of a miserable failure, tatty looking object, that's spots galore. Beautiful flower though, if it ever decides to do it again. That's my miniature, that's Delenartii, and it's the Alba version. Not bloomed for me yet, and this is the typical thing you end up buying, a single growth path. Single growth paths are not strong. They need the support of the various previously bloomed growths. The one at the back is Mordii, and that is what I'm getting at. I mean, that was bought with two growths, one in flower and one with a bud. Both of those bloomed, the blooms lasted for absolutely ages and it's now pushing up new growths. But the old growths are supporting the new growth. So that's a strong plant. That's pushing on, dare I say, at a fairly high rate for one of these things anyway. That's my best one. It's the one I'm most pleased with. And it's easy to understand why. You know, it's got the support. All these growths are joined together. And they support a larger, stronger plant. So you get multiple growths coming out, you get multiple blooms, and you end up with a bush heading towards a specimen plant with multiple blooms, hopefully at the same time. That to me is the goal with this type of plant. And the rest of them live down here on this bottom shelf in various stages of growth. Some have got some nice strong new growths and one older growth. There's a couple of single growth ones that lost their older growth, so they've lost their support, so they're back to a single growth plant again. They're all growing, there's nothing wrong with them, it's just painfully slow. And I've had to move these. I used to utilise the whole of that shelf and keep all of them together. But, well, the shelves above used to let quite a lot of light through, and then the orchid fairies came in and filled up those shelves with orchids. I just don't know how that happens. And so the light level became a bit too low for them. So they've all had to move out to the edge of the shelf so that they get additional light from above. I think they're doing a bit better as a consequence. I'm not going to name them all. They're all in various stages. They'll get their own little videos, especially for them, if they decide to ever put any blooms out, which hopefully will be later in the year. There's a fair few growths are starting to mature there, so they should come on. Okay, so that's the paths. Okay, these are my two Psychopsis. The good, the bad, and the downright ugly. those are the three stages basically. That bloom died a while ago, it just didn't fall off. Just needs a bit of help, there we go. And right behind it is the next bud, pushing on nicely. That's what they do. Okay, this one here is just going over, so it's not going to let go of that bud just yet, but again, you can see the new bud coming on behind. This is a small plant, it's just pushed on a new growth, and I still maintain that is as a direct result of being repotted, because this plant has done nothing for a long time. It's flowered on that existing spike, but it's done nothing. And basically it came out of what was a manky bit of media, got a nice new place to live, and promptly pushed out what I hope will be a nice strong new growth. And let's hope that this one does the same. This is a more mature plant, but still only the two spikes and no signs of new growth. And when I bought this, it was in quite a small pot and it was a solid mass of roots. And in those days, I was a bit nervous of such things, shall we say. I'm a bit bolder now. And so I teased a few roots out, like you would say a normal plant, not an orchid, and put it in some new media around the outside. And some roots grew into that new media, but it didn't solve the problem of the solid mass of roots in the middle. And so it lived like that for some time. And again, it bloomed on those two spikes and everything was fine, but it didn't grow. So I had to take the bull by the horns and literally strip it right down. It came out of its pot and everything got pulled apart, washed and everything like that, leaving, I must say, not a lot of good roots, but some, enough to keep that plant going. So it's now in new media, the same as that one's just had done, and I'm hoping soon it's going to push a new growth out. On a plant that size, who knows, it might push out two, or even three, or just one will do. I'll live with just one. You know, it's not a bad plant, but it needs a new growth. It needs to push on again. New growth, possible new flower spike, maybe three, maybe even four. But that one's at least made a start. So that's my two Psychopsis. This is the sort of species, Papilio. It's the alba form, going over now, but you've seen it before. And this is Psychopsis, that's Hildos Mendenhall. A good one, basically. Good strong bloom. Okay, that's the two Psychopsis. Okay, the Vandas then. This is the one that I bought not that long ago. It's my newest one, I suppose. And it has that very large, almost white bloom with the deep purple small lip and the silvery grey tessellations, which everybody seems to think might be lavender mist, but without a positive ID, what can you do? The roots on this were buggered, to coin a phrase. It was in a pot of like polystyrene perlite stuff that was soggy and wet, and a lot of the roots had to be cut off. They were in a state. Well, not anymore. This is what we want from poorly rooted Vandas. That had lost its growing tip, that root, and now it's decided to push out two tips and several branches. This tip has recovered and started to grow again, and this big long root, the only long one it's got, is sprouting in various places. So a root recovery. There's some more sprouts around the back as well, but I knew these roots were viable. You know, they're good plump roots, but they had no growth tips on them. Well, now they have, and it can push on nicely. I doubt if I'll get a bloom on that this year, but hopefully I'll push the roots on before our poor light levels kick in. That one up there with the spikes, it's got three spikes on, one on the left, and one creeping along the leaf opposite, and one creeping along the leaf above. That's a species, that's Roblingiana. This is my first blooming of that beast. That's been sitting around doing nothing for ages. The tatty base on it was not my doing, that's how I got it, but it is producing a kiki, which hopefully will fill in that ugly looking gap at the bottom. The one in the basket next to it has never bloomed. It was bought as a young Vanda, and this year, if you look at that top growth on that plant, that's pushed on really well. Its roots have really, most of those around the back, you can't see them, grows away from the light, that's what they do. If I turned it, the roots would spread more evenly, but you know, they're okay round one side of the plant. I grow it for the plant, not necessarily the roots. This poor thing was the one that suffered the worst, shall we say, with my previous problem that has now gone away. And the new root growth on there is looking pretty clean, especially around the back of the mount. So we have solved that problem once and for all. Rest of the Vandas, this is my orange delight, I believe. Not necessarily so, but that's the closest I can find. That's growing well, soaking wet at the moment. It's just been in the bucket. So lots of roots, happy plant. I may get another bloom off of that this year, maybe not. These two are young plants. The one in the little baskets pushed out a lot of new roots and several new leaves this year. And the one on the piece of driftwood is coming on nicely. That suffered a bit with some root burns, but the tips didn't go over on that one. So it's continued to grow and some of the roots are starting to branch now. So he's coming on. And the other one that's in the bucket, that's doing its thing in there, having its morning soak. Again, never bloomed for me. It's got a it's a type of vanda that all of the names in the cross are hardly pronounceable. So I'm not going to attempt it. Okay, so that's the vandas. I haven't got a lot, but the ones I've got I'm pleased with. And certainly since switching to an organic fertiliser, quite honestly, they're doing better. It's noticeable, even though it's only a month now, maybe 5 weeks, they're noticeably growing better. So they're happier. Happier vandas, happier Roger. Okay, that's the vandas. Right, so this is the Brassavola group. There's only three. It's not much of a group, is it? Three-piece band, as they say. I've included the Rhynchocalia glauca in this group simply because it was once Brassavola, and that's where it's staying in my mind. So this has put on a lot of new growth. It lives up with the vandas now. I can't give it any more light without putting it outside, which I'm not prepared to do. It's growing well. It's a substantial plant. If it doesn't bloom this year, we'll see what we can do next year, because it only had part of this year in that extreme high light situation. So maybe it will react to that light next year. This is this huge new growth sticking into the camera here. Let's turn it sideways. This is Brassavola David Sanders, which is I think it's a primary hybrid, but it might be a cross between, I think it's Digbyana and something else. And this is the species Nodosa. This actually bloomed, which on such a young plant, I was impressed. Now that these two don't live in the highlight situation. They live in the next best thing, which means they are right up in the roof, very close to the roof, almost touching. But there is a bit of shade netting over that part of the roof. And the fact that Nodosa bloomed in that situation, I see no reason to move it. If it did it this year, I don't see why it shouldn't do it again. David Sanders hasn't yet bloomed. Again, it's not a mature plant, really. It's still quite a young plant. But the new growth on it is considerably bigger than the previous growths. It's doing well. It's suffered a bit in the root region, as all three of these have, but to a minor extent. You know, they still had plenty of good roots on them. The damage that was done is minimal. I'll live with it. They're pushing on nicely. So that's my three Brassavola types. Okay, this little group of four are the prosthetias, some of which have had their names changed, so, you know. Anyway, this is Garciana. This has bloomed for me, and this boy has this plant suffered with the old scale. I just could not shift it for such a long time. I think I've finally got rid of it, but it's pushing up plenty of new growths. Some of which have got sheaths. This one here has got a sheath in it. So it should flower again soon. It's recovering. I just couldn't shift that scale from this plant. It's as though they got coaches and had special trips just to visit this plant. I think I've finally shifted it. It's a fast grower, so it's going to recover quickly anyway. I mean, it's a good sized plant, very good sized plant. Lovely flowers. What else have we got then? We've got this one, which is a strange plant because of what it is. It's a cross between green hornet, which is a prosthetia hybrid, which we all know and love. Everybody knows that one. It's got some two good new growths pushing on there, but it's crossed with an epicatlia, which is a strange mix, and that has blooms. You have to excuse these, they're going over. This is green hornet, and the blooms on this one, if it ever gets round to it, are the same size and shape as that, except for this, see this deep colour here? The whole bloom is that colour, apart from the little stripes in the lip. So it's an unusual version, shall we say. Be nice if it flowered. Green hornet's doing okay, it's got some strong new growths coming out. Blooms are just going over now. It's been out visiting shows and things. And the other one I've got is, that's the one with the posh label, which is radiata. Again, the blooms are just finishing now. I think that's about the last one that's in good nick, and the others are going over. But again, lovely strong new growth coming up here. Another one round the back there. So apart from the fact it's in a ridiculous size pot for the size of the plant, this came from Burnham's as a special for me. When they split up one of their specimen plants, I had one of the splits, and so it was potted by Burnham's. And it may be that they know more than me, and the fact that this might spread, it might be one of those where the new growths actually spread away from the plant. I think I've got at least two plants in that pot, and possibly three, but only two new growths at the moment. So the two previous growths, which I grew on myself, both flowered, so it's obviously okay and doing fine. So that's the prosthetias. These are my two Rhynchostylus giganteas. Managed to say that first time. I did have a practice. Okay, this one's in chunky bark, and it has grown a new root on the bottom. Excuse the dripping, just been watered. And I did notice, need another hand, it's actually going to branch on that root there. So good. So again, I'm trying one in chunky bark, so there is air around the roots, although the first really decent new root managed to escape. So I'm trying to work out the best way for these. I've got two. I've actually got another one coming. Yeah, I know that's greedy, but it was going cheap and it was a good sized plant. And this one's growing in absolutely nothing. Some people do that. All those old dead roots in there, what I thought were old dead roots, have actually, or in that particular case, sprouted. So that root wasn't dead. So a couple of nice new growths on that root there. It's one root that it already had. When I first got it, it just made the side of the basket. And you can see the join there where it effectively had stopped growing. And then it just found a new growing tip, and it's pushed that root on since then. It doesn't look the best of plants because the old leaves were desiccated when I got it. So those two lower leaves and the one just above on the left, that's sort of how they were. However, that's my first new leaf, and as you can see, there's another new leaf coming out there. So hopefully that will do okay. If I find signs of desiccation on the new leaves, my new leaves, then I will add some media. I'll actually get some of the roots in some media just to hold that moisture that little bit longer. So that's those two. Okay, the Psilogenes then. I'm not digging that monster out because that's where it lives, and it gets watered there using a sprayer. So it actually is pushing out so many new growths. I'm well pleased, but if they're going to do anything and mature good enough to flower, then it's going to need watering a lot more than I have been, shall I say. And that means it gets one of those good sprays with a reasonable volume of water every day now. I need to push it on. So that effectively is, it's Cristata lemoniana, which apparently is due to the hybridizer's name, not the color of the bloom. But if it ever blooms, I'll let you know. So that's the mother plant. Too old to crawl around like that. And when I split it up, these were the two splits that I put in open baskets. This one I'd given up on. This was the manky one, the tatty one, that I thought I was going to throw away. And then lo and behold, it's chucking out new growths. So it gets to stay. Whether it gets to be kept long term or not, I may actually swap it for something or sell it on. And then the other one that I did at the same time is the better version. And this one's got some good new growth pushing. The older pseudo bulbs are a little bit shriveled, but not dramatically. So it's actually got some backup for these new growths. So that one's pushing on. So that's two of the same, effectively. And then this one, this is Flaccida. This is the one that's been sat there for a year doing absolutely nothing. And it is pushing a new growth. And I do see signs around that side that there might be a little brother or sister coming on. So it's decided to grow, slowly but surely. This one is Fimbriata. Now this is a creeper. This is a terror for getting out of the pot. Overpotted? Absolutely. Ridiculously too large a pot. This is a shallow rooted creeping phylogeny. It should not be in a deep pot full of moss and junk, and there's some flipping coconut husk in there as well. But it gets neglected, it gets shoved up the back. But what I did do is take some bits off and mount them separately. And this is the one that's doing something. It has something sticking out the top of that pseudo bulb and out of the side. Well, one of those has got to be a flower spike. They can't both be new growths, so I assume I might get some flowers on that. There's a beautiful flower on that and lovely scented, and is due to be watered right now, which is why there's another one coming out the side there. So this bottom section is moving. It's doing stuff. The top section is reluctant to start, but given how long that one took before it moved, that one should follow on soon. And then this little plant that I'm bringing on, this was Orchracea, I think that was pronounced, but they changed its name to Nitida. Basically a very young plant. That's its new growth around this side, so good sized bulb. It's now right over the side of the pot because it wasn't put in the right place in the first place. Should have allowed room to grow, shouldn't I? But it needs coming out of that pot. I might do that. In fact, I think I will probably do that, like now, and get it in some better media and centralise so that it's got some room to move if it does decide to push out a new growth. So a very young plant that I'm sort of bringing on. And then this monster over here is another Burnham's Nurseries. This is Moriana, which I was after for a very long time, and another special favour. This is Magnifica, and it's the Brockhurst version. So it really does have large blooms on. This growth here is mine. It was one that I pushed up, as was this one. So those are my two new growths, and it's now pushing another one up. So it's got a hold in the pot. It's pushing on nicely. I don't know what flowering season that is, but it's a monster of a plant. But hopefully, whatever season it blooms in, with three decent new growths on it, two matured and one pushing on, I should get at least one spike on that. Well, when it's time, shall we say. Okay, so that's the phylogenies. Not many, and a bit neglected in some cases, but they're starting to grow, so I might give them a bit more attention, shall we say. That's the phylogenies anyway. Well, this poor little thing lives all on his own. He's a set of one. In his dim and distant past, many, 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 many moons ago, it was actually classed as a dendrobium, but it's been a bifrenaria for so long now, he lives in a set of his own. A name change I'll accept. Ooh. Now, since he got mounted, he's pushed out some roots and two new growths, the one at the back. The flowers are highly scented, nice sort of waxy flowers that come out near the base of the plant, I believe. I'll let you know if it ever happens. But that's two good strong new growths this time round. Now, whether that's enough to mature that plant to flowering size or not, I don't know. I may have to wait for the next set of bulbs. We shall see. But I mean, it was bought as a young plant. It's pushing on some good new growths. So that one lives on his own. Poor little thing. Orengus. Now we'll start with the I often do the good, the bad and the ugly. Well, we're starting with the ugly. That is a naff plant. This thing will not pick up. That tatty looking leaf with the scabby bits on, that was its last new leaf. It now is trying again with another new leaf. It has actually pushed out some roots, but it will not kick off. It's fastuosa. Yeah? Yeah. Fastuosa. And it has another one. Don't know why the hell I ended up with two. I think I got given one a while back. This one isn't doing so bad, but as an example of the plant, it's still not good. But it's kicking out a little side plant. I was hoping that was going to be a flower spike, but it's a new little plant look coming out the side. So that one's doing better. Probably, I mean, these are miniature plants, as arengis go. But whether that's actually mature enough to flower or not, I don't know. But it just gets watered, it gets looked after, it lives in the right place, and I don't take much notice of it. This one, however, I love. I mean, this one did suffer a bit with some of the old root damage, but it's pushing out nice new clean ones now. And this, as a plant, has branched successfully in both directions. So the original plant is the centerpiece, and the two side plants, one sticking out each side. So that one is pushing on well. And that is, oh, I can never say that. Oh, I can't say it. I'll put a pop-up. And that's not my label. If it was my label, I could read it. Okay, that's that one. And then there's this one, which I also like, which turned out to be two plants when it came out of its pot and got put on its mount. Again, the new roots on this are good. And it's these new ones around the back have just happened in the last month or so. So this is pushing out good new roots and two happy little plants. And this one is, the label's fallen off, I'll have to look at it in my records. But those are the small arengis, and then the one of fame, of course, you know, the big one, this is Alyssii. This is a good plant. I mean, I really like this plant. That was my leaf, bigger than all the others, obviously. Well, not obviously, but it is. And a nice new strong leaf coming on behind. I would like to see a new one of these. This is my only root. This root buried in here was a new root growth when I mounted it, and it decided to just abort, so it lost its growing tip, and I was a little worried about the plant. When it arrived, it was covered in algae. All the roots were green and algae and a bit slimy, so I had to do my best to clean them all off, and then it pushed out that root there, decided to extend. So those are new extensions, and it has attached in places. But this is its first brand new root, and they don't seem to show active tips on these roots. They seem to grow so far and then they just stop. Now that could be me, and it's not meant to be like that, but that's how it is anyway. And this one did suffer a bit, as you can see. But nonetheless, it's still a viable root, it's still very active, it still waters well, and at long last we do have the blooms. So my only arengis in flower at the moment, but a good plant. So that's my little set of arengis. A nice genus, I like them. They're all African or Madagascan from that era, hence the sort of night-scented, pollinated by moths, yellowy-greeny flowers, with huge long nectar spurs. Yeah, that tends to be how they are. So a nice little genus, and that's my good plant. That's a sort of like my pride and joy, really. It's done well for me. So arengis. Okay, I'm breaking away from the original plan of doing these in sets, because there are a couple of sets, no names mentioned, Cattleyas, Oncidiums and Dendrobiums, that are just too big to do in one hit. Plus they're all over the place. So although these are probably classed as Cattleyas, some certainly one of them is, to me they're still Sophronites. So there's just the pair. There's this one here, this is Cernua, and that's pushed out some real good attaching roots recently. wonder why. It has got a nice new growth coming there. It's had other new growths on it. Never flowered for me yet, but there's hope. It's a nice plant. It's got a nice root system now. It gets the appropriate amount of light and everything, so it does stand a good chance. And this is the cochineal or cochineal, however you would like to say it. It's doing new growths. It's got one there, and two round the back. So it's doing new growths at the moment. It had an attempt at pushing out some nice new roots, but they got taken off, shall we say, annoyingly so. Nonetheless, it's got a root system that will satisfy that plant. This one again did push up two new growths earlier in the year, but they didn't bloom. Three, in fact, come to think of it. And no sign of sheaths or anything, so no sign of blooming at the moment. It's now got four new growths coming on, and I'll see how I get on with those. This has flowered for me once, but not since. And this is a variety Japan, which means it has slightly larger flowers than the normal. But it's still a nice plant. I like the plant. I love the dark purpley stripe down the centre of the leaves when they're new. They just look nice. I think that's just a Cattleya now. Well, not in my book, it's not. It's Sophronitis, that's how I like to call it. So that's just a little pair of Cattleya types that stick out one side, and I may do the same with the rest of the things, divide the dendrobiums up into smaller sets and what have you. We'll see how we get on, and we still end up might having to have part one and part two. We'll see how the day goes. Okay, that's those two. Right, these are my two little Neophanesia falcatas. This is the one that, to coin a phrase, I got very pissed off with. This is the one that really got badly damaged. And the roots are brown stained, they're not good. But as you can see, those roots have now started to push on clean. So I'm well pleased with that. Yeah, nice new root tips back again. It's on the mend, and it's never going to look as good as it was. It's bloomed, so it did well at that particular point in the year, and then it had a little bit of a hiccup, shall we say, but it will recover, and eventually new roots will come from the base and older roots can perhaps be snipped off at some point in time. It's a lovely little plant with its variegated leaves, lovely highly scented blooms. This one, however, has not bloomed for me. And bearing in mind these two were growing next door to each other, you couldn't get a more identical set of circumstances. This one never suffered. Well, it did very slightly, but, you know, I can live with that. So this one growing right next door to the other one just didn't fare badly. It's pushed out some lovely new groups, roots, despite the adverse conditions that it was given. It survived it. It's pushed on well, and it seems to like being on that mount. There's a lot of new fans pushing up in that plant. So that's bushing up nicely. It's actually two separate plants, but eventually they will merge together and look like one. So I'm pleased with that one. I was pleased with the other one, not so much now. But that's my two little Neos. One day I will get a pink one. I want a pink one. But at the moment, both of these are white-bloomed varieties. Strangely enough, that smaller plant has actually got larger blooms, if it ever does, than this one. But this one was got simply because of the attractiveness of the leaves. I'd have that plant if it didn't bloom. So that's my two little Neos. Some people are going to want to know what variety they are. I'm not going to try and say it. But is that showing up on the camera? Yes. So if you can have a go at that, that's up to you. That's that one. I don't speak Japanese. And that one's my label, so we'll be a little bit more readable, shall we say. And yes, that does say Vanda in brackets, and it's in brackets, and it's staying in brackets. These are Neophanesia falcatas. You can rename them as often as you like. They're staying with that name in my place. Okay, that's those two littles. Okay, so that's part one. I'll move on to part two and what might end up being part three as well as soon as I can. I think it's going to be a hot sunny day, which means I need all the fans and everything switched on in here, which is not ideal for filming, so I may start again tomorrow morning. Anyway, part one done. Thanks for watching. Sorry it's a bit long, but there's an awful lot of plants to get through. See you next time.